against Bilibili Gaming. We'll start with remote submitted questions first, and then we'll move on to the live questions. The first question comes for Stax from Strafe Esports. Congratulations on the win. DRX and Comeback has to be the best duo in Valorant right now. The defensive half was flawless, but it seemed DRX's attack didn't look convincing at all. Multiple players died to the utils and it looked sloppy. What was going wrong here? What was the case for the slow start?
일단은 아침 처음 경기였던 것도 영향이 어느 정도 있는 것 같고요. 몇 번 얘기했는지 모르겠는데 이거를. 그리고 이제 뭔가 저희가 좀 팀 준 거는 그만큼 저희가 조금 많은 클루를 좀 줘가지고 그렇게 된 것 같아서 조금 더 조심해야 될 것 같습니다.
Well, people ask me this already multiple times, but you know, we weren't really used to getting our biorhythm ready for waking up so early and playing game one. So I think that kind of affected our performance in the beginning, in the first half. And I guess during those rounds, we were giving away too much of weaknesses or clues, as Dex said, that the opponents might exploit.
Thank you. This next question is to Termi. After the win over Nadisv and Seer on Bind, was there something concerning about the game or the composition that you chose to ban it today? Or was it something about Bilibili's Bind?
감독님께 드리는 질문인데요. 바인드 밴의 이유가 뭔가 지난번에 바인드를 해보고 조금 보완해야겠다고 느끼신 건지 아니면 빌리빌리의 바인드를 보고 밴하신 건지 궁금합니다.
빌리빌리랑 바인드 스크린을 몇 번 한 적이 있고요. 그리고 NRG와의 경기를 봤을 때 바인드를 굉장히 영리하게 플레이를 했다고 생각하고 그거에 NRG가 무너지는 모습을 보면서 상대적으로 바인드가 좀 강할 수도 있겠다 생각해서 밴을 했습니다.
We've screamed Bilibili on Bind before, and watching them play energy on that map, I think that they play Bind very smart. And watching energy also crumble to Bilibili, it just made me think that maybe their Bind is relatively strong. So I decided to ban that.
Thank you. This next one is to Zest from the Valorant competitive community. You've been playing a lot of Viper when you haven't before. What is it about Viper's play style or how you utilize her that allows you to be so impactful at Champions?
Zest 선수에게 드리는 질문인데요. 일단 예전보다 바이퍼를 훨씬 더 많이 기용하는 모습인데 좀 이 요원을 기용하는 이유와 좀 어떤 점이 마음에 드는지 아니면 좀 효율적인지 궁금합니다.
아무래도 일단 수비 때 막는 힘이 센 게 좀 강점인 것 같고요. 저희 내부적으로도 굉장히 좋은 요원이라 생각하고 있었어서 그런 것 같아요.
Well, she's extremely strong and holding the site on defense. And I think we rate her as a really good agent as a team. So I guess that's why we're running Viper a lot these days.
Thank you. We'll now move to the remote and in-person media. If you have a question, please use the Zoom hand raise function and we'll call on you. Would anyone like to go first? I think we'll start with a question in the room. Bo?
Hi, this question is for Termi. During Lotus on the second half, you guys changed up the game. Would you say that the map is more like defense favored, or would you say that it came up to like your countering of Bilibili?
감독님께 드리는 질문인데요. 로터스 후반전에 더 좋은 모습을 보여줬던 DRX였는데 로터스가 수비 맵이라고 보시는지 아니면은 그냥 수비 때 빌리빌리를 잘 카운터 친 거라고 생각하시나요?
로터스는 개인적으로 공격이 더 좋은 맵이라고 생각을 하고 공격 때 안 풀렸던 이유들을 후반전 넘어오면서 그런 얘기들을 잘 해서 저희끼리 마음을 다시 다잡고 좀 수월하게 풀어나갔던 것 같습니다. 그리고 대응도 선수들이 훨씬 더 잘했던 것 같고요. 전반전부터. 그래서 이겼던 것 같습니다.
I would say Lotus is more of an attacker-sided map. I just feel like during the halftime, we were kind of talking about why we weren't playing the rounds. We weren't playing out the rounds properly. And we were able to resolve that coming into the second half. And we managed to regroup during that halftime. And I guess the players responded better to Bilibili in that second half.
We'll go next to Razor from the Valorant competitive community.
Hi, my question it's for the team in general. But today you guys started Lotus being down 2-10, but managed to pull off an incredible comeback, winning 11 rounds in a row. Who would you say are the team's emotional leaders, and what do they say to the team to keep them believing that a comeback of that magnitude is still possible?
이거는 아무나 대답을 해주시면 되는데 일단 2-10에서 11라운드 연속 따내면서 로터스 승리를 가져갔잖아요. 이럴 때 좀 선수들의 사기를 돋아주는 그런 감정적인 리더가 있는지 그리고 있다면 어떤 얘기를 팀원들에게 해줬는지 궁금하다고 합니다. 아무나 대답하면 돼요.
제가 분위기를 좀 잘 이끄는 것 같아요.
I think it's gonna be the line.
아니 뭐야 형들 다 축 처져 있을 때 제가 좀 긍정적인 말을 잘 해주고 터미 형도 와줘가지고 할 수 있다고 얘기 많이 해줘가지고 저희가 예, 희망의 끈을 잃지 않고 후반에 잘 뒤집을 수 있었던 것 같습니다.
I would say me, Buzz. That was Buzz's answer, and I tried to keep the energy up when my teammates seemed down, and Termi also came in, talked to us saying, you know, you guys can do this, don't give up. And we were able to keep the positivity going, and that's why we were able to push through Lotus and eventually close it out. And Stax kind of said, that's a lie. So,
thank you.
Thank you. We'll go next to Ganesh from Strafe.
Hi, this is Coach Termi. We usually see coaches burn both their timeouts when their teams are struggling. We saw that same from DRX today. DRX was struggling on Lotus, but you held on to one of your timeouts. What was your thought process behind this decision?
허미 감독님께 들리는 질문인데요. 보통 감독들이 좀 팀이 흔들리고 있을 때 타임아웃을 많이 쓰는데 이번에 로터스에서 흔들릴 때 타임아웃을 많이 안 쓰셨거든요. 그래서 좀 어떤 결정이었나요?
전반전에 상황이 좋지 않을 때 타임아웃을 두 번 쓴 경기가 몇 번 있었는데 후반전 때 타임아웃이 없는 게 너무 큰 리스크라 생각했고 선수들이 극복하길 바라는 마음으로 쓰지 않고 기다렸던 것 같습니다.
Well, in our previous matches, I have, there were games where I called timeouts, both of them in the first half. But for me, it's just not having those timeouts in the second half. I thought that was a huge risk for the whole team. And I was kind of hoping that our players would pull through.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any more questions for DRX? Go ahead.
This question is for both Termi and Stax. You guys have had more than 8 days to prepare for playoffs. Do you feel that this has been enough preparation for you guys to win the entire tournament?
터미 감독님과 스택스 선수에게 드리는 질문인데요. 일단은 8일 정도 플레이오프 준비할 기간이 있었는데 좀 이제 우승하기에 좀 충분 우승을 위해서 준비하기에 충분한 시간이었다고 보시는지 궁금합니다.
연습 기간은 충분히 길었다고 생각하는데 저희의 뭐 완성도로 치면은 뭐 아직 100%까지는 아닌 것 같고요. 남은 기간 동안에도 꾸준히 연습을 해야 100%가 될 것 같습니다.
시간이 많았다고 팀 합은 올라갈 수 있지만 조금 그것 때문에 우승할 수 있는 건 아닌 것 같고 저희가 이제 실수를 덜 하면은 충분히 노려볼 만한 것 같습니다.
Well, Termi's answer was I think 8 days were enough, but what's important is to perfect our form and be in our best form. So I guess we really need to practice and push ourselves till the end. And Stax's answer was, well, that was enough time, but just because you have enough time doesn't mean that you can win trophies. It just means that your teamwork's maybe gonna get better. So I feel like if we don't make the mistakes and if we correct those mistakes that we've made in the past, I think we have enough to, you know, maybe get us a title.
Thank you.
Thank you. Last call for any questions for DRX. Go ahead.
This question is for Buzz. You mentioned in the past before that for DRX to reach a new heights, you need to step up and perform better. After your MVP performance with a 10-2 comeback on Lotus, do you think the team reached a new level today?
버즈 선수에게 드리는 질문인데요. 이제 마스터즈 때 이제 팀이 더 잘하려면 더 좋은 성적을 내려면 내가 해줘야 된다라고 얘기를 하셨는데 이제 오늘 2-0을 뒤집은 그 승리의 주역이잖아요. 그래서 이제 버즈 선수가 이렇게 잘하니까 팀이 어나더 레벨을 찍을 수 있을 것 같냐고 물어봅니다.
그때는 이제 저나 형들이나 뭔가 좀 힘든 심적으로 뭔가 힘든 게 있었어가지고 제가 좀 더 잘해주고 싶은 마음에 그런 말을 했었고 이번에 뭐 이대용으로 뒤집은 거에 저도 어느 정도 일조는 했지만 저는 극히 일부라고 생각하고 형들이 정말 잘해줘가지고 제가 거기서 조금 더 빛날 수 있지 않았나 싶습니다. 그래가지고 네 저는 별로 잘한 거 없어요.
Well, back then when I gave that interview in Masters, everyone was going through a rough patch emotionally, especially. So I just, you know, that was my answer to kind of keep the energy up and make sure everyone stayed positive. That's how I eventually wanted to contribute to the team getting better. And as for today, I guess I did kind of deserve a little bit of credit in flipping the 2-10 and making a comeback. But I think most of the credit should go towards my teammates. They've really, you know, done a great job in making that happen. And I guess because they were supporting me very well, I was able to shine through. But I really think that they deserve all the credit and that, you know, it's not a, you know, not a pop star performance from me.
Thank you.
Any more questions for DRX? DRX, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.